You are now listening to Simbang Finance Podcast.
Yo, what is up people? Selamat datang ke lagi satu episode Simbang Panas.
Kau ada baby terbangun ke apa?
aku lupa kita ada baby. Okay guys, so kita baru saja kembali di second episode of this hot topic. Yeah. Tapi sebelum tu jangan lupa podcast kita ditajakan khas kepada anda oleh teman-teman kami daripada Ace Realtors SG. Untuk masyarakat, demi masyarakat.
Jangan lupa untuk follow rakan-rakan kami di Instagram dan juga TikTok acerealtors.sg.
Jadi kalau korang nak beli rumah ke, nak jual rumah ke, tak payah pening-pening kepala, korang boleh saja hubungi ejen-ejen yang bertauliah daripada Ace Realtors SG.
Korang juga boleh terus hubungi mereka di talian 88779923. 88779923.
Suara DJ saya.
It's only that part. Very
okay,
deep.
Itu part je. Kita akan jumpa korang sebentar saja nanti. Let's go.
Podcast cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro ini. Podcast cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro ini. Podcast cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro ini. Podcast cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro. Siapa-siapa boleh go, semua kita undang. Siapa berani masuk, jangan sebab temberang. Alkisah bikin panas macam goreng pisang itu sudah terang. Panggil semua geng-geng minat untuk jom masuk gelanggang. Jom masuk studio, dan berapa banyak idol. Kita kasih sampai viral, Alkisah dapat title. Ini Simbang Panas, it's love for the week. Ini Simbang Panas, real love on the mix, boom. Simbang panas, 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 panas. Simbang, simbang panas, 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 panas. Simbang, simbang panas, 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 panas. Simbang, simbang panas, 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 panas.
Yo, what is up people? Nama saya Aidy Isham,
Anazia,
Liza Malisa,
Saifu Jazeh.
Dan kalau korang belum lagi follow Simbang Panas, tolonglah follow dulu. Lepas tu jangan lupa untuk rate kita punya podcast. Kalau boleh kasihlah 5H.
Campak ni microphone.
5H.
5 bintang. Okay, jom kita start balik topik tu.
Tadi aku nak tanya. Tapi tanya korang list. Kita move to the second part, right? So just now you left off, you say that you didn't approach the issue because you feel that you were at fault. Kenapa? Because like based on your story, we don't see anything that is your fault. So which part?
Okay, pasal dia cakap I am not earning.
Okay,
I'm not earning well. So memang I cannot pay for my rental fee. So that's why I macam, oh okay lah, that's why I just shut down lah. I tak bayar dia, I tak bayar rental fee. Seriously, this is serious story. I mengaku that I never pay her. So after that, baru Sis Fatia ni approach me. Mm-hmm. And she told me that whatever reasons that she give you, she have been using it to everyone else.
Okay, kejap. Not earning meaning like nobody buy from your vending machine, so tak boleh cover ke apa?
Tak boleh cover. And actually ada orang beli kat my vending
but
machine.
But you still top up right every month?
I still top up. Actually
mana
I top up.
Mana beli apa?
Yeah. At that period tak terfikir. Macam percaya sangat dengan dia, tak tahu kenapa. Tak terfikir langsung.
Dia pakai benda.
I suspect lah.
Kalau tak
panggil kisah
ada mandrum sikit ke.
So
okay.
Tak tahu pula vending machine bila letak barang.
Memang lah letak barang lah. So orang nak keluarkan.
Okay,
bye.
Jadi bila Sis Fatia approach me and tell me this, that's where I started to sit down, fikir tau. Fikir betul lah. Fikir. Pasal my capital covered for January dengan February apa kan. That's why I said tadi lah, the like previous episode I cakap it's supposed to cover, I'm supposed to get my my sales. Even kalau Melissa kata March, April, May tu tak cover, I should still get my money, right? Tapi kenapa aku tak dapat? Baru terfikir, aku kena bodoh-bodoh lah.
Okay, but how did you found her? Like, because
how you found each other? Yeah.
Okay, for me, I was triggered to look into this matter again is when my ex-bride, WhatsApp me. Okay, dia apa, tanya I, DM I lah. Because she knows I do vending machine.
Correct.
Because I promote on my social media.
Oh, okay.
So dia tanya, are you still doing vending machine? So I'm like, okay. Alamak, masih ada orang tanya eh. Because I thought people dah tak follow. Because I dah tak post pasal vending machine lagi apa.
Okay.
So for me, I thought it's like a failed investment lah. Then after that, I look into it. Then after that, I message si scammer ni lah. Si scammer ni. Tanya like, okay, what's ni dah too long. What's the update? Okay. So she keep on saying, oh, company tengah audit.
Company tengah
for
audit pula? Okay.
Cakap, audit, that is the same reason that you gave me last year and last year and the first 3 months during.
Namanya audit dia.
Dapat every month audit pun.
Dah share audit dia.
Tak ada. Pasal audit ni, there's when you you need to reach a certain level, okay, baru your company can go for auditing.
Auditing, yeah.
Correct.
Okay, so one of the three criteria is your business have to be revenue more than 10 million.
Wow. Patutlah kita tak ada orang audit.
Then,
jangan tahu ni.
Oh, sorry.
Second reason is kau punya asset nak kena more than 10 million.
Okay.
So for me, kita have our own infos and one of the kakak yang scammer yang victim who came approach me, okay? Dia dah hantar surat lawyer and everything.
Okay.
Alright. So dia dah hantar surat lawyer to find a house. Member tak ada nama, tak ada rumah under her name.
Tak ada rumah under her name.
Jumpa tu? Tak ada. So rumah yang address yang dapat tu okay, is either the sisters punya or the company.
Mana you dapat address orang?
Mana boleh bilang ni.
Ini tak ada orang, tak ada orang. Tak pergi serbu ke. Even though kakak dia, so you can still find her through the sister what?
Yang ada kak family cover family mah.
Oh,
but surat letter lawyer tu yang one of this kakak hantar dia dah dapat. Alright, she even went to the court. Then she was supposed to pay 16,000, but she only managed to pay 8,000. So it's a small claim
tribunal
court order. Alright, so the balance 8,000 ni sampai dah 2 tahun ni pun masih dia ni belum bayar.
Sangkut lagi lah.
Kira yang dia sepatutnya bayar ni tu siapa?
To one of the victim lah. Yeah, that approach me.
That file a report first.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay,
so
okay.
And the one is the first two kan. Second is you need asset more than 10 million. So kau tak ada asset sandeng kau. Alright. The third one is your company must have more than 50 employees working under you. So kita dah pernah pergi dia punya warehouse.
Okay.
When I went there, I can only see 4 and including dia 5. Okay. So kalau kau maybe macam like a restaurant Saffron ke ada few branches, maybe kau boleh jejak 50 pax lah. Tapi kau warehouse kau satu je kecil tu yang dekat Ubi tu. You're telling me you got 50 workers.
Oh, dia dekat lah.
Okay, I want to ask you mentioned you dah pernah pergi warehouse dia. So after this case, korang tak serbu warehouse dia lagi ke?
Sekarang kosong ke macam mana?
Dia baru buat live. Dia buat seorang
dekat warehouse tu juga?
The same warehouse.
Ya, yeah, dia tunjuk diri sini. Asyid, all my machines.
Dia masih promote.
Masih. Nak cari new victims.
Okay, jom. Yeah. Paling tinggi sana.
Jom, what up guys. So, hari ni I nak beli new machine.
Jom.
Pasal budak-budak dah bising, prime ni botol banyak sangat.
Beli machine. Dia nak letak dalam beli machine.
Wait, so that means dia... Yang tadi yang you cakap dia kena bayar tu, that one was from the report that you made.
No, from another victim.
Another victim.
Yes, another victim ni dia dah proceed legal.
Tapi dia tak bilang siapa, dia tak macam huha kan?
Tak, dia tak buat huha. So she stumbled across my post, right? Then baru we created a group chat lah.
Okay.
So, and then she said her story. Dia dah pergi up and down the court and everything. And she was pregnant at that time, heavily pregnant, kau naik turun court.
Kesian dia.
Then another victim, okay, ada anak special. Kau sauk dia punya duit.
Aku paling pantang part ni tau. Bila buat bisnes
tak berkat si
dia. She's a stay at home mom. She wants to do a sideline lah, cause dia tak boleh keluar kerja.
Dia kena anak.
Kau sauk duit dia. Hajar. Then another victim, okay, dia jaga mak dia very ill, dialysis. Dia minta duit balik. Aku nak buat bayar hospital bill. Nak buat ni lah everything. Sampai mak dia dah arwah. Kau rasa aku patut diam?
Ish, I get goosebumps. Pasal rasa macam
yeah. So because these victims approach me tell me that their background stories, then they kena gini-gini. Mm.
Yeah. That's why you decided to...
Yeah, I decided, but before I blast out, I already message her. Aku kasi kau time. Mm.
Okay, you want her already?
I
lah.
Want her. Okay. I want her. Dengar aku bodoh lah.
I want her. Kasi sama dia sis.
I want her. Kalau kau tak kasi aku punya duit balik, yeah. I will blow this thing up.
And then what she say?
And dia macam our audit will finish in May.
Dia masih dengan
May. Masih dengan audit dia.
Pasti sekarang dah June. Masih audit.
Tapi kan aku realize something. Scammer nowadays kan, lepas diorang scam, then orang dah dapat tahu diorang scam, diorang masih thick skin tau. Diorang masih either minta pity or diorang still continue their business as if like they are not in the wrong.
Tak ada hal gitu.
But okay, one of the victim, okay, is a good friend of Maya. So she's in the industry juga. So she saw my post. Then after that, aku kebetulan berjumpa dia dekat Angsana. So dia cakap, dia approach saya, eh fan, aku kenal dia ni, kau kena scam dengan dia. Aku kena dengan dia 20 tahun yang lepas.
Wow.
2004.
Lama betul kena. Makan duit haram.
30,000 aku kena daripada dia.
30,000 at that point of time is a lot.
Big money.
I know it's also a lot, but and at that point of time
30,000 is sekali one
so
time shot.
One time.
You don't.
Okay, so time apa? If it's not vending machine though, what was it?
It's still vending machine still. Tapi this under licensing your program. So she told me lah the story that she was seated inside the room with two lawyers.
Yeah.
Right. So she kena connect, and that time was she was younger lah.
Yeah.
They kena pressure. So she just paid 30,000. Then after that, when she asked for the invoices and agreement and everything, delay, and then the same issue, the same reasons against the audit.
Mak kau masih
oh, dia punya level of berani is beyond eh.
20 tahun saya kau punya company audit. Lu suar busy Mina.
Ada juga another people yang comment kat my post, eh dia ni masih hidup eh. Dah 24 tahun masih buat kerja gini. So
almost our age
24 years. I am not surprised kalau ada orang 30 tahun lepas pun kena. But they don't want to come they don't want to come front
forward lah.
Yeah, they don't want to come forward.
At the moment, how many is with you in your team?
Now yang sekarang dah yang dah buat police report dah 10.
Okay, now I'm wondering, if you guys dah kena kan, and ramai orang dah kena, and you all make police report ready right? Like, is there nothing that the police can do ke macam mana?
The police can only do if there's dia pandai kan, sebab main law kan. So the police can only act if they say there's a court order.
Okay.
So now siapa-siapa yang kena scam tu, please come forward. Okay. Kalau kau rasa kau tak kena scam, kau rasa kau percaya dia cakap-cakap, kau baca balik, kau read back. For me, that is why I like, okay, bila I baca balik this back, oh my god, I didn't see this red light.
The red flag. So during at that point of time, kirakan korang dah macam termakan lah dengan kata-kata manager.
Yes. For me okay, for me, because I told I got 4 machines, right? Mm-hmm. Right. So one is the rental. Then I decided to get an ice cream machine. Mm-hmm. And I decided to buy 2 machines. Mm-hmm. So this 2 machines, supposedly, she is supposed to put at SMRT punya location.
Uh-huh.
And sampai sekarang, SMRT location pun habuk pun ada. Right? So, legitly, you should just refund me. Bro. Kau tak dapat location. So, you just refund me lah.
Kalau tak but refund pun, kasih balik tu 2 vending machine lah. Simpan kat rumah.
Tapi tu, the vending machine tu, actually, I just deposit aja.
Okay.
So nasib baik I did just deposit. There was one point of time dia Facebook Messenger ya. Dia cakap can you transfer me the balance remaining 8,000 tak? I ada some issues with my credit card and I cannot that time dia dekat Turkey apa lah. Then I'm like, aku dah minta aku punya report, aku minta aku punya sales proceeds, kau belum kasi. So I'm like, okay, aku maybe I'll just say I got no money. Just say sorry, I got no money at the moment. Anyway, you belum ada confirm the locations and everything. No documentation is done. So I just say I got no money lah. Then after that, later last year tu, dia cakap okay, memang legit dia tak menang this SMRT punya location. So
tak dapat demi bidding lah.
Pasal so, refund balik lah.
Asal sampai sekarang kau tak refund balik.
Oh, tak refund balik.
And how much was that?
The deposit aja was 1,005.
Okay, for 2 machines.
For 2 machines.
So it's tricky.
1,005
tu grant for 2 machines lah. Both machines deposit. So masih baik Allah lindungi I, dia tak suruh I transfer that 8,000 for that machines.
So total how much you kirakan macam wasted on this investment?
How much did you really took up?
For all, okay, the stock so ni is already like 10,000 plus. Right. Then after that plus this 1,005 deposits, so
about 12.
Yeah, so 12. The stock saja kalau korang times 3 jadi berapa? Berat duit aku.
Yeah. Asya banyak asya duit.
Untuk Mimi pula.
For yourself.
For me is around 5k lah. With the capital, with the sales,
yeah,
with the stocks.
Boleh buat
so family macam-macam boleh pergi sih.
Tahu siapa itu duit boleh pergi apa tu US lagi.
Your husbands react when they find out like macam ni scam, korang kena marah ke, ke dorang yang macam eh pergi getak tu Mina ke?
Yeah.
Kan I dah cakap dengan you ni bedek ni.
When I started ni benda when I want to start these things right, I ask my husband lah. He's been very supportive of me whatever I want to do. Jadi bila kena macam gini kan, dia of course dia marah, not marah to me lah, dia marah dengan dia lah,
the situation so, lah
he lepaskan gerah by saying nasty stuff but not to me, just that lah. Tapi going to her house kena gertak ke ni, my husband have to think lah, there is a consequences if he do that.
Correct.
So it's not the right thing to do that lah, so we let the law talk.
So go the legal way lah.
Do the legal
but
way.
But when you guys were going through this, like, of course, I'm pretty sure korang share the journey with your husband. Husband korang pun tak realise any red flag ke along the way?
Tak, husband aku ni baik sangat lah.
You lagi fierce lah dari dia.
At that one point of time, I told him, eh, kita dah tak payah stock lah. Tak payah stock up lah. I don't see my money back. So, we just stop lah. Terus cakap, tak lah kan agreement dengan dia kan 1 year. So
dia punya husband's on game strong lah.
Kalau apa-apa jadi nanti I tak nak get involved. Dia cakap okay lah, kisah you lah. So stop. Yeah. Then after that 1 year, we already fulfilled ni. Then
the contract.
Aku minta dia balik duit aku. Masih minta where's my proceeds, where's my ni. Kali baru dia minta, do you keep track of your stocks? Do you keep track of all the apa?
The sales
The sales ah. Then you apa? You put in for the stocks ah. Macam dia ni bodoh apa? Aku mesti lah aku buat.
Yeah. Experience. It's a business what?
You have your own business. Of course I keep track.
Correct. Exactly.
So I gave her the Excel sheet. Sampai sekarang pun still nothing. So dia macam dia nak test. Dia nak test whether I got keep
kira
track.
Kira you don't keep track, aku lagi selamat lah.
Boleh pilih lagi lah.
Yeah. Tapi the thing is, salah orang aku nak makan.
Takde, the fact that she's doing this for years already eh.
Yes.
Kira berapa banyak orang dah kena makan, dah berapa banyak orang kira yang
20 years doing plus this of scam.
Makan duit haram all the way lah, like I said.
And I heard, that this person had actually appeared in a podcast to promote her business.
Yeah.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, so I think that is also one of the reason macam
credible lah.
People think it's credible.
Yeah. Okay.
Wait, aku nak tanya dulu. Now this person yang scammer ni, dia punya, I mean you guys mesti definitely know dia punya own personal punya social media and all that, right? How's her lifestyle? Like, dia ada post-post ke? Macam have sikit-sikit pergi holiday ke?
Sekarang dekat overseas, right?
I'm not sure.
Oh, sekarang dekat overseas?
Yeah, sekarang
Turkey.
Tak tahu
lah. Turkey
lagi. Tak ada, yang penting satu cakap sekarang dekat overseas kan, dia dah entah, tak tahu lah.
Dia dah pasrah sangat.
For me, I have to keep track juga pun.
Yeah.
So now she's at overseas. So apparently yesterday she finally sent a letter. Alright, send a letter to me saying that she out of goodwill. She will refund me that my 1,005.
Goodwill.
Lepas tu the pink story dia cakap because I cannot fulfill external commitments in financial. Sebab tu dia nak kasih balik duit.
Kau masih salah dia.
Kau yang tak kasih aku location, kau tak menang tu bidding, kau nak ping story.
Cakap dengan dia.
Kasih sama dia sih.
Aku rasa macam aku pula yang kena marah.
But I feel the anger. Let's go.
Kau kasih ping story, kau cakap aku yang tak ada duit. Aku ada duit edit, aku boleh bayang kau. Tapi kau yang tak fulfill kau punya agreement. Lepas tu kau punya letterhead. Company mana yang tak ada logo company, UN number, taruh cantik-cantik. Itu
tak ada.
Secondary school pun boleh buat. Semalam aku tak sebenarnya, aku kasih kau pun boleh apa.
Kira dia hantar letter Microsoft Word ni lah.
Tak ada anything on top.
Tak ada. Dia kan selalu promote dia punya
logo
colourful.
Ni lah akibatnya makan duit haram banyak sangat.
Dia dah panik. So suddenly some of the victims suddenly we got our
I got my invoice guys.
Semua orang dapat invoice.
Dapat invoice I tak bayar.
You tak bayar, bukan dia yang tak bayar.
Dia kasi apa yang I tak bayar.
Eh, kurang ajar untuk perempuan ni.
Because you said that you stop paying right at that time, right?
Yes, I stop paying.
Okay, sabar. Satu benda, yang next punya transaction semua masih tak dapat lagi lah sampai sekarang.
Tak dapat.
Oh,
kau tapi
got
she got the cheek to send you all invoices.
Exactly.
What the hell? Yeah.
Liz, ada budak Liz.
I said what the hell, babe.
Nasi dia tak faham.
But the thing is, I got to give her one credit.
Okay.
How she swerve for 20 plus years. Maybe sampai 30. Sekarang lawyer letter pun maybe satu kali aja dia pergi, dua kali dia pergi. And scam so many
Dini,
people.
Dia ni, kalau dia masuk MLM business, dia paling
dia
fly.
Boom. Dia paling confirm fly. Boom tahun cali punya.
Dia actually bukan scammer, dia con artist.
Yes, con artist.
That's the title we should give a round of applause.
Dia tinggal mana? East side, west side, north side?
Sekarang dia tak ada address kan? Dia tak ada rumah kan?
Dia floating.
So dia tengah floating. Dia tak tahu mana dia punya address. Dia punya real.
Mana tahu dekat Taiwan tiba-tiba.
Sekali dia duduk sini, Ubi.
Dia nanti bilang kau, kau kena minum 10 Bias Life S kan? Kau kurus dalam satu hari. Kau percaya kan?
Macam pernah dibuat orang. Tapi
kau sialah saya. Kau ikutkan bunuh.
Kau babi lah.
Dah. Sekarang kita berbual pasal lain.
Okay, when you posted and then macam everyone start to come to you one by one. Now I just want to ask, like the rough number lah of how many victims yang datang dekat you and share dorang punya story.
Sekarang at the moment we already have 10 yang already reported her.
Okay.
Police report. So I'm waiting for more. Siapa-siapa yang kena daripada dia, please come forward.
Yeah, okay,
please
go.
Approach her.
20 years ke, 24 years ke, 30 years ke, pergi je.
Dia ada duit to even like ask Zul Arifin to scam. So maybe not lah kan. So Zul Arifin to be an a brand ambassador, you know. So but there's a lot of pending payments that korang dia owe orang. So just stop lah.
Yeah, I just cannot brain ya. You dah warn dia that you're gonna take this action.
No.
And yet she want to send you invoice.
Yeah. I just okay, my post actually ada dua. Okay, the first one, okay, dia tak nampak. Dia tak nampak until aku gatal pergi PM dia punya kawan dia. So make sure kawan dia nampak aku punya post.
Kawan dia akan share kat dia.
Share kat dia.
Asal dia tak nampak.
Mungkin dah flooded, dah banyak sangat orang diam dia. Terselit somewhere.
Some Facebook, they will just show you certain people that you will communicate with.
I don't use Facebook.
Sorry lah, my generation. So so kawan dia, after I DM her friends, the next hour terus she start commenting her. She commented on my post.
Oh, she commented.
She reveal herself.
Dia cakap apa?
Tak mention pun nama dia.
Tak mention pun nama dia.
Siapa makan sini terasa pedas.
Yes, the commenter. Then after that, then
trying to defend herself again.
Trying to defend herself and trying to cari orang terima salah. Macam cakap, dah bagus aku tak charge kau warehouse fees. Okay. But orang yang dia kena ni, kan, mesin pun tak nampak. Macam mana kau nak charge warehouse fees?
Tak charge warehouse fees.
So I asked the victim, kau pernah tertanya dia tak, what is the vending machine yang you already purchase from her? The serial number. Aku tak terfikir lah.
Oh yeah, everything
should be. Ini confirm dia pakai barang
tu, tu satu.
You blank eh. The way you just blank.
And another thing, kalau tu vending machine dah dekat location, kau dah charge aku location fee. Habis aku charge warehouse fee untuk simpan apa?
Simpan dia.
Simpan parking lot untuk vending machine ke?
For those tu, kirakan machine tu diorang nak, diorang buy, then after that diorang nak jual balik, kirakan something like that.
Tapi isn't that business cost?
Tapi dia cakap
within your pocket
ber. Dia cakap dia it's okay, I absorb the cost of the warehouse fees.
Kalau silap dia beli 10 je, that 10 dia rolling and rolling and rolling. She only bought 10 ni.
Then she just say
kau tahu yang dia patut audit apa? Dosa-dosa kos dia betul
ni. Tapi Allah je audit
lah. Maybe pula audit dia.
Kira tak macam orang pergi nak makan nasi padang kan. Habis makcik tu charge kau pasal ikan tu dalam refrigerator sebelum masak.
Ya.
I like that point. Yes, you're smart.
Storage.
I give it to you.
Yes, kau dah benda san. I love it.
Makcik letak ikan dalam vending machine, kau mana tahu.
So she play this kind of grey areas that orang macam rasa, oh shit lah, better aku just diam. Aku tengok aku kena bill lagi. Then after that nanti mesti aku kena bayar. Cause I already lost belasan ribu daripada kau. Sama ada yang sampai 50 ribu sekali sahut pun ada.
Ada satu orang 50 ribu?
RM50,000 sekali sekali.
Ya Allah.
Sedap. Ada yang
beli or rent ke macam mana? Dia beli cerita tu.
Oh, dia beli. Yang RM50,000 ni beli. Then ada, she was saying that this point of time ada Qatar World Cup
World Cup.
Aku masih lupa je. This World Cup kat Qatar. So you can just kau ada 11,000
vending machine kat Qatar?
Serius? Kau jatuh 11,000 aku settle kau punya location. Aku orang kat sana top up. Kau tengok at the end of the month, kau kasi duit jatuh je.
Tapi
duit,
dia selalu pergi Turki, bukan Qatar.
Dekat apa?
Dekat. Dia suka main Middle East punya story.
Oh, so wait, vending Mekah machine dia kira not only in Singapore base.
Kejap. Mekah pun ada. Dekat Tanah Suci pun kau nak scam orang.
What is the age
dia
group?
Dia pergi umrah dengan curious about that. She went umrah with Zul Arifin.
Astaghfirullahaladzim.
Kau dengan duit haram kau pergi umrah.
Astaghfirullahaladzim. Ayu aku terkeluar.
Okay, ada takut pasal agama ni semua.
Dia ada Facebook kan. So what is the age group yang, okay, out of this 10 lah, kita take this sample size, the age group, our age group.
My age group, I guess.
Cik gitu. Ada yang lebih older ke, yang baru dapat CPF ke, like yang
so I think for this, all this con artist, the older you are, the better for me to eat your food.
Yalah, pasal kalau scam kat Qatar, kita yang young ones will be thinking, tak boleh lah, siapa yang nak pergi top up kan.
Tak, dia cakap ada orang kat sana, ada company sana will run for you.
Jadi so dia charge lebih lah.
So at the end of the day, kau just collect duit je.
Oh.
Ni yang after I realise that okay, macam dah nak forward, dah nak lupakan pasal dia. Tiba-tiba dia keluarkan this kind of business scheme. So got a lot of people who DM me.
The more and more I listen to this, right, smart. You know it looks like what or not? Apa macam dia? Let's just say dia pergi Qatar lah ya. Let's just say dia cakap, oh nak 15,000 jatuhkan, then can put, then tiap bulan collect duit kan. Aku rasa dia kat kedai LV, dia nampak 15,000 punya bag, dia macam okay, jom kau nak 15,000.
Ada
maybe
ada chance macam gitu lah. Because at the time of inside one of the conversation, dia cakap credit card dia dah maximum, dah max out lah.
So dia nak bayar tu.
So can you transfer me lah the money. So
wait what, dia cakap credit card dia dah max out, lepas tu dia minta can you transfer me money.
Tu sekiranya to pay off yang the
credit card dia,
to pay sekiranya for her expenses.
Okay lah, kan dia cakap dia pakai credit card dia tu untuk for the stocks and expenses.
Tak. Okay, kan dia sendiri, dia tengah holiday dengan Zul Arifin lah ni.
Kesian si Zul ni. Saya kena sebut, tersedak.
Dia memang sampai.
Okay. So, Zarifin kat depan muka kau tak nak minta. Zarifin kan kaya.
Tapi mungkin Zarifin nampak dia ni ada.
You never know, dia pun dah kena RM100,000 ke.
Mana tahu. Sebab she has a machine with his face on it. No, perfume. Perfume.
Yes, perfume.
Yeah, so it's an ambassador. She wants Zarifin to be an ambassador.
So
time yang dia pergi umrah tu lah dengan si Zarifin, she did message me, credit card dia dah max out. So maybe dia dah spend dengan
and she ask you to pay her credit card.
Kena bola.
Dia dah roll the money. So she
Apa pasal Zul Arifin tak tangkap? Because most of the money maybe yang semua that made losses, right? Yeah. And the money that she collect probably to pay Zul Arifin for his
Kita tak mahu
Zul Arifin kau tengah sibuk cari polis yang makan rasuah.
Dah habis. Cerita tu dah habis.
Makcik makan rasuah kau tak nak tangkap.
Sila tangkap ya. Sebab dia dah dengan plan nak pergi Malaysia. So orang Malaysia kena beware.
Oh, dia nak expand.
Kejap.
Dia nak expand to Malaysia.
Wait, so when she was in Mekah, she max out her credit card. She text you for money me to pay her credit card.
No, to pay. Kan I purchase, so called I deposit for two machines. So she asked me to pay for
the
that
balance,
the balance.
But at the same time, she told you that her credit card Max out.
Budu siya, yeah, budu siya. Dia pergi bilang
kau tak scam.
Dia pandai play with feelings and empathy. So pada aku like, kau kat sana dengan Zulifin happy-happy, aku lagi bayar
ni dekat mana budu? Dekat Mekah.
Oh,
Dekat Tanah Suci pun dia nak scam orang.
Dia beli apa dekat Mekah sampai boleh max out credit
card?
Kurma.
Tapi the fact that she can still be in Tanah Suci and still nak scam orang.
Yeah.
Like what the
mungkin dia dah tak ada tu perasaan dah 20-30
okay,
years.
How long ago was the she went together with Zul Arifin?
Last year.
Was that the only time she went together with him, or got several times she go already with him?
This is one period lah.
Yeah, it's one period.
Dia buat macam umrah dengan si Zul Arifin.
So there was back and forth lah.
Macam pergi umrah, lepas tu dia pergi Qatar ke, tak tahu, Doha ke.
Lucky, you know,
according to her,
dia tengah nak cari locations for us. Then kan dia cakap ada company nak invest, nak beli dia punya company for $40 billion. Dia reject duk.
Aku tahu company apa nak beli company.
$40 billion lah.
Aku kasih kau $1 million, kau nak berhenti kerja tak?
Of course lah.
Ni 40 billion 40 kau tak nak?
40 billion sih.
40 billion.
Dia reject tau.
Dia reject. Fuh. Sebab dia cakap idea dia worth trillions of dollars.
Oh wait, now I remember who this person and which podcast.
Yes.
Oh bloody hell, I know already.
Okay, okay.
Siapa? Sekarang kau kasih aku curious tau. Kau tak mau cliffhanger aku.
Shit. Dia punya yet satu macam saya dalam tu podcast.
Yes.
Bih nampak dia punya merepek
Level world.
Berperak dia.
Lebih lagi teruk daripada tu Mamak World yang gemuk tu sial. Yang kat China sekarang.
Taiwan.
Tak mana-mana lah.
So jangan main. Ideas dia aku boleh kasih kredit lah. Engkau punya licik is memang trillions dollars lah. But you just step on the wrong person lah.
Okay, I just nak tanya like, okay, kalau yang tadi you cakap dalam 10 orang ni kan that actually came to approach you guys, berapa like kalau you tahu each and everyone kena punya
losses,
kira
losses lah. Kalau nak do rough calculations ada 100 lebih lah.
Compilation dia
compilation
about 100 over K.
Out of 10.
Okay lah, business dia trillions of dollars pun.
Ni baru 10. Kalau let's say yang bertahun-tahun ni semua, wah betul lah, billions lah, betul lah. Ya, ni baru 10.
Yang kena 50,000 one shot tu dia tak nak buat report. Sebab okay lah, I understand she has her own business at the moment, so she wants to protect her name. So okay, But I say if you never come forward, even though you have business, you know, she is still continuing, and then she is scamming
others. Victims,
If you don't report,
pandai cari orang,
you know? You can come to our podcast, share your story, tapi kita sensor muka.
Anonymous lah.
Tutup muka.
And how long has she been doing the vending machine? Yang so far yang
50K ni.
Dia cuma beli je, lepas tu bau pun tidak.
Oh, tak dapat the machine at all.
What, tak sempat.
Tak sempat. Then sama. The same reason is just like, oh, machine dia ada something wrong with the shipment.
Itu boleh report sih.
Then after that, masalah macam-macam. The same ni audit lah, stuff tak boleh lah, machine rosak lah, coils tak ada. And bila you compile balik, it's like, ni reason dia dah kasi dia ni. Dia dah kasi dia ni. Apa sih sama?
Okay, now I want to ask this to the both of you. Now you definitely got your own things to do dekat luar sekarang. And you guys taking the first step and tengah cari lagi orang untuk compile the story to make it stronger and all that. Apa dia punya purpose dia? What is your main intention actually?
Okay, for me lah, my intention is to, because macam dah 20 tahun when I heard that she have been doing this for 20 years. I feel like kenapa macam masih boleh continue ni. Like there is no stop. Tak ada orang nak stop pun. So I feel like okay, social media is very strong now. Kan correct. Kita gunakan that platform lah to bring her down. So everyone akan kenal siapa dia. Dengan nama dia dah tahu, oh dia ni jangan lah, jangan main-main. So I want everyone to know who she is, bring her down and make her stop everything.
Just make sure there's no future victims. Because some of the victims really kesian. You want to earn side income, then you kena sedut dengan mereka sekaligus. Then after that, kau dindong dia orang punya background, kau tak tahu, kau main sedut, lepas tu kau tak kasih duit balik. Really just cruel lah. You just inhuman lah. Senang cakap.
True.
Orang lain kita bertungkus lumus nak cari rezeki yang halal, kau haram jat tu lah. Serius macam
ni kira another level of Melayu. Makan Melayu je suara rabak je. Tapi sometimes aku really just wonder tau, all these scammers macam even the one that we shared, yang credit card punya scammer yang epok-epok scammer tu. Macam dia tak ada hati perut ke And sometimes this yang orang-orang yang diorang scam
is like,
these are the people
very vulnerable
that, vulnerable. And they themselves definitely have already shared dengan kau diorang punya own problems that they are facing. So macam that like is tadi, the reason why they want to do this business with you and get the extra income. And kau tetap ada hati dunia
duit haram siapa korang makan.
Yeah, so that's why I mean, at first me and my husband discuss, cakap, tak apa lah, Allah akan ganti, kita forget it, just move on. But then after that, more and more people DM me, approach me. Then I'm like, okay,
That means, their story kesian
Yeah, I mean, if I am the only one, maybe this is bad investment. Maybe aku seorang je yang kena dah kerja. Then slightly got a lot more yang kena. Then those yang kena yang dah lama, mereka tak kuasa nak cari the receipts and everything and to file a police report. So, bagi sedap lah. They keep on scamming people.
Correct.
So, it's just not right lah.
But one thing memang for sure lah, we got to applaud both of you for being the one that step up, come to the front,
being the voice of the victims.
Banyak, I mean, like there's, and the fact that they masih lagi buat live, masih lagi nak promoting, that means there's definitely that possibility that makin ramai yang akan kena. And jangan cakap yang orang-orang kita punya age, budak-budak sekarang pun ada yang dah banyak duit juga. Yang mana tahu diorang ada yang terjelumus ke, termasuk, termakan demi kata-kata, kena pukau ke. Kan? So I think it's good lah whatever that you guys doing. And also aku dengar recently dia, yang tadi aku dah ternampak, ada someone
she actually
send us during kita punya break tu. Apparently some people already dah tangkap who we are talking about, and hantar
a screenshot that she of did punya police post. Report saying that she filed a report of defamation, and then after that she apa tu blank out the details. Tapi dia punya blank out memang macam budak-budak. Aku dah boleh sekali glance tu, aku dah boleh nampak poster kod dia.
Poster kod dia?
Sekarang masalah dia, kalau macam ikut cerita tadi, dia tak ada rumah. Poster kod tu rumah siapa?
Mungkin rumah kakak dia lah, like mention just now.
Ada rumah kakak dia, office dia.
Aku nak cari lah nanti poster kod tu.
Nanti aku cakap poster kod dia apa, kita search.
Dia tak ada rumah, dia tak ada landphone number pun, it's not hers. So
that means she pandai gila.
Dia pandai.
Reminds me of that movie Catch Me If You Can. Do you watch?
Dia pun macam apa, Anna Delvey.
Anna, yes, correct. Also the same.
That level lah.
Did she ever like contact any of you guys yang buat police report yang ke depan sekarang ni?
Sampai sekarang dia belum. Sebab kalau tengah tunggu.
Maybe after this podcast.
I mean like if kau boleh post your own police report on one person, and that one person is not towards you, right? Your name,
I don't know lah. Tapi she's telling people that
it's you,
it's me. But when you trace back, ni bukan nama aku, bukan starting nama aku, bukan poster aku. So kau try and gain sympathy from the rest. So if you had attacked me for defamation, it's okay. Kalau kau rasa kau betul, aku minta maaf. I can pull down this post, I can get it over with. Tapi kalau kau dah memang salah, just,
and it's not just you, there's many other people that come across. Yeah, there's many other people.
So that's the thing. Story semua sama. Sama reason. Kau tolak staff kau, staff kau sakit, kau sakit. Dan daripada post pun, tiba-tiba kita dah viral, eye patch.
Baru ni recently. I saw that too.
Aku tanya kawan aku punya nurse, korang nurse belajar dressing macam ini ke?
Itu macam orang tampar sendiri.
Dia tampar sendiri ya?
Tampar sendiri.
Tuhan. Then after nampak that, Tuhan tarik pelan-pelan. Mula-mula mata.
The recent post pun, they keep on signing 100 pages of sign. So,
100 sih?
100 sih.
Apa yang dia sign?
Tak tahu lah. Hopefully ada orang beli over dia punya company lah. So, kita boleh dapat kita
nyari. Dia practice autograph. 100 invoice nak hantar ke 100 orang.
Boleh. Kau nak hantar aku invoice boleh. Kau kasi aku punya inets. Aku, I just want the sales report from you to tell you from my side. Kau ingat aku tak keep track on aku punya stocks? Aku keep track. So I just want to tell you. So kalau dah tell you, of course the money is you need to give back my money. Kalau aku dah put $10,000 in stocks, asal kau tak boleh kasi aku punya 30,000 times 3 apa? Habis apa every month? Then kalau nak tolak rental, tolak berapa? Busuk-busuk 20,000 mesti aku punya duit. Sampai sekarang pun tak ada. Then dia macam licik lah.
Aku tak tahu macam mana. And apparently from the thing that people sent to me, went over to dia punya profile, surprisingly tak ada hate comments. Surprisingly, I think in the live pun tak ada hate comments. Orang support dia, orang cakap syafakallah lain.
Yang okay, moderator dia Game Strong.
Siapa komen? Dia block weh.
Tu ada moderator dia.
So one of my friends, alright, managed to dig up on her. So she has owed her staff lah, so called. She has owed her staff a few dollars, and then I didn't keluar apa that you are apa ada issues, never pay your staff. So then my friend also pinpoint her mistakes lah and everything. Tu member kena block. So whoever yang nak attack her, dia kena block.
Boring.
So orang tak tahu. Even kau buat
macam budak-budak
kau buat dia pula block. So like so orang kalau buat fake account pun dia kan tetap block. Dia rajin, dia rajin.
Terlalu free.
Dia belum kena dengan budak-budak fake account kat TikTok. Oh, masak kau, masak. Tu baru cik Saiful. By the way, back story tadi.
Kurang ni.
Tak ada. I was just macam tengah lap-lap meja. Lepas tu Saiful nak kena kangku. Dia cakap tak ada list nak score point. Cik ada anak. Tentu aku macam, kau panggil dia cik. Dia level kat Ana si, panggil kak si.
Ya, sama age si kita.
Ya. Panggil cik.
No, I'm cik Ana also.
No, kau ingat kau muda mana? Kau dah anak dua tau, ingat tau.
Memu muka.
He's being humbled right now.
Aduh, tak boleh tahan. Tapi serius lah. If let's say lah, if let's say dia punya, I wanna say, Ada victims. Victims definitely please come forward.
Please
report dan report strength kepada kakak ni. Dia tengah kolek-kolek.
Dia and nanti then, fall in semua ni.
And then at the same time, sekiranya lah, aku tak tahu whether dia ada staff yang bukan family members ke apa. But if let's say lah, any one of you guys pernah jadi dia punya staff ke, pernah
ex-staff apa
ke, yalah, korang actually the strongest person to actually come forward and share. Especially kalau korang tahu dia punya lubang-lubang kat belakang ni. So kalau tak, if she goes down one day, which most probably seems like soon, dengan korang-korang sekali ya terbabit nanti.
Correct.
Kalau Zul Arifin nak masuk podcast.
Kalau Zul Arifin aku nak join.
Tadi kala-kala Zul Arifin, sekarang nak tarik balik.
Dia tarik balik guys.
Okay guys, whatever it is, I did nak cakap once again, thank you so thank much you for coming forward. Hopefully that bitch goes down soon lah.
Yeah man,
aku dah tak boleh cakap baby.
Yeah, cannot already.
Ada putak. Tadi aku maki korang.
Dia tidur. Tadi aku maki dia bangun.
Tadi tengah panas.
Once again, thank you so much for coming forward. Thank you so much for sharing your story. Hopefully dapat balik tiga kali ganda the amount that you guys lost.
InsyaAllah. Definitely pahala dengan rezeki also.
Ya, pasal tolong yang those yang victims.
Saman tu kalau boleh times 3 harga yang korang lose lah.
Betul.
Minta-minta boleh menang. Guys, tapi walau macam mana pun, jangan lupa untuk korang-korang yang tengah dengar ni, if you guys are planning, okay, untuk make extra income ke, nak cari cara senang ke, nothing comes easy in life lah.
Betul.
Saya cakap, semua benda pun nak kena, definitely you need to put your work into it. So skim-skim cepat kaya ni, jangan cepat percaya.
Betul.
So, and jangan lupa podcast kita kali ni ditajakan khas kepada anda oleh teman-teman kami daripada Israel Test SG. Untuk masyarakat,
demi masyarakat. Jangan lupa untuk follow rakan-rakan kami di Instagram dan juga TikTok israeltest.sg.
Jadi kalau korang nak beli rumah ke jual rumah ke, tak payah pening-pening kepala, korang boleh saja hubungi ejen-ejen yang bertauliah daripada Israel Test.
Korang juga boleh terus hubungi mereka di talian 88779923. 88779923.
Dan kepada makcik tu, aku nampak juga post kau ada cakap siapa-siapa yang nak jadi middleman ke, nak jadi apa ke, be careful pasal nanti kita terbabit juga. Jangan risau, kita semua dah kena polis report dah 3-4 kali dah.
Tak lama we'll lagi kita ada frame.
We'll be waiting for you too, yeah. Okay, jumpa korang di episode terus. Sembang Panas.
Betul, tak ada soro-soro ini podcast cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro ini podcast cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro ini podcast cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro. Siapa-siapa boleh go, semua kita undang. Siapa berani masuk, jangan sempat terberang. Alkisah bikin pada macam goreng pisang itu sudah terang. Panggil semua geng yang minat duduk, jom masuk gelanggang. Jom masuk studio, dan berapa banyak idol. Kita kasih sampai viral, Alkisah dapat title. Ini Sembang Panas, it's love for the week. Ini Sembang Panas, real love on the mix, boom. Sembang panas, 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 panas. Sembang, sembang panas, 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 panas. Sembang, sembang panas, 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 panas. Sembang, sembang panas, 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 panas.